Hello there, welcome to your weather update from the Met Office. Storm Jocelyn will push across the country overnight tonight, the full brunt of its winds felt across most places. Here are your warning zones. Across eastern counties, the Midlands, mid and southern parts of Wales, gusts could reach around 55 miles an hour. Further north, it's slightly higher for Northern England, Northern Ireland, as well as Scotland. And here's your amber warning extending from the tip of Aberdeenshire, Orkney, Caithness, down towards the western side of Scotland. Here we could see gusts up to 80 miles an hour. That's high enough to cause power cuts, fallen trees, flying debris, and there's a risk of disruption yet again across many parts of the country with those strong winds. Added to that, we do have some heavy showers with the risk of thunder and hail, particularly across Scotland, the far north of England, as well as Northern Ireland. Further south, this rain will clear southern counties into the first part of Wednesday morning, and then we'll see some clearer skies. But a windy end to the night and incredibly windy towards the north. Severe gales extending towards Orkney as well as Shetland. And gusty over the mountains, Pennines as well, as temperatures hold around 6 to 8 degrees Celsius. And first thing, we continue to see that rash of showers, which will be heavy at times. So through the morning, brighter skies across England and Wales. More cloud moves in across the southwest through morning into the afternoon. Some showers just skirting Northern Ireland, but some drier skies here. And slowly, the winds will lose their sting through the afternoon away from Shetland and Orkney. But still, we'll see gustiness over the higher ground of Northern England, Scotland, even the far north of Wales. And later on, a few showers here and more rain arrives across the far southwest. Temperatures then holding up 9 to 11 degrees Celsius, relatively mild for this time of year, certainly compared with last week. So a quieter end to the day on Wednesday, and for many it's relatively dry as well. Rain will continue to skirt the home counties, southern counties, perhaps even clip the far south of Wales through evening time on Wednesday. Clearer skies elsewhere, just one or two rogue showers clipping the far west of Scotland. But through the night, the cloud will thicken as this rain marches towards Northern Ireland, Wales, as well as the southwest Midlands. Temperatures, though, across more northern and eastern areas dipping quite quickly, so we could see a patchy frost. Certainly that will be the case across central and eastern areas of Scotland. But that ridge clears off the scene as this warm front moves from the southwest towards the northeast. And then we see a returning cold front pushing down towards the far southeast as we head through into Friday. It turns windy then, blustery breezes, showery bursts of rain, and a lot colder, but some quieter weather into Friday across more central and southern parts of the UK. Further north, we'll see some showery bursts and always the risk of some gales here into the weekend. So wherever you are, the next 24 hours are quite critical in terms of wind, but then the winds will slowly ease before we see this rain on Thursday just push slowly towards the northeast of Scotland. And then some heavier pulses of rain move in across Northern Ireland, Western Scotland, Wales, Northwest England. And the winds turn quite gusty associated with this cold front. Another cold front will again bring with it some showery bursts and some squally winds. But then eventually we'll see some settled weather just extend across more southern areas. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.